We wanted to share some of the changes to the animation window in Unity 5.5. The first big change is the box tool. It's a much better way of selecting and working with keyframes in your animation. The box tool allows for improved selection and editing. To begin, drag to create a selection. Then using Control, Command on Mac, and or Shift, add and remove as you would expect. Adding keys to the selection expands the box. You can drag within the blue highlighted area to move the keyframes. You'll see numeric fields indicating the start and end frames of your selection as you move it. You can use the box tool to scale the animation too by dragging the handles on the edges, easily causing your selected range to occur over a longer or shorter period of time. You can also ripple, a common feature of editing timelines which allows you to push the surrounding frames along the timeline when moving a selected range. Invoke ripple by simply pressing R on the keyboard when you're about to move or scale your selection. You'll notice that frames surrounding the selection adapt to maintain their relation to it. Curves mode also has some updates. First, when selecting a keyframe, you can see the beginnings of the box highlight tool, allowing you to easily spot your selected keyframe in the timeline. Naturally, as you select further keyframes, this also forms the box tool we've just looked at. The great thing about the box tool in curve mode is that because we allow for scaling with the box, you can invert the scaling too. This includes the tangents, giving you all manner of flexibility with how you design curves. Another key new feature is the introduction of a new default for curve tangents. When you place a new keyframe, the default tangent will be clamped auto, a new key type that avoids all overshoot or undershoot of the curve by auto-flattening the tangents at the minimum or maximum value of the curve. This auto tangent is time dependent and based on the slope between the previous and next keyframes. This gives far more predictable curves as you move keyframes, and automatically switches to free smooth as soon as you adjust the handle directly. Finally, we've made an array of optimizations under the hood that make working with the animation window in Unity far smoother and performant. We hope you enjoy the new workflow changes, and we'll be adding further animation additions in future versions of Unity. So please sound off in the comments below as always. Thanks for watching.